Ready to eat.
Yeah, ready to eat, and they've got some stuff for like these little hand rolls for $5, or they got the trays all the way for $18. And I know, you've known me for a long time. Usually I'm pretty much of a snob. I mean, for me, like, it has to be either like Tattinger champagne or something like that. And if somebody brings over Cooks, Barefoot, I'm not gonna drink it. But when I go to these supermarkets and I get the sushi and a six pack of Sapporo, it's pretty good.
It's pretty good. You don't send the sushi back because it was raw. You're not that much.
Gotta be fresh.
This portion of our show is brought to you by Barbecue's Galore, and we have sushi. That would make no sense. That would be like saying jumbo shrimp, right? Like a barbecue.
Oxymoron.
That's the word that I'm getting to. All right. So we are going to give away this box of goodies that Sapporo USA has supplied us. And a little later in the show, I am going to say the magic word. In fact, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to have Dory type it in right now one more time on Facebook. I'm not going to say it here on the radio, but we'll give you guys a heads up. And if you want to win this box, you got to email me. Simple. Peter@diningwithgills.com. Peter@diningwithgills.com. Phil lives in Long Beach, and a bunch of people on Facebook have been talking that Vegas is open, and I got no problem plugging that Vegas is open, and they're partying like it never existed. But in your neck of the woods, Phil, in Long Beach, Joe's, the place you turned me on to, Joe's is now open.
Joe's
is now open. There's two places I want to go, Phil, when I see you next. Maybe we can do a caravan. I want to go to Joe's Jost and have an anchor steam with the hot dogs and the peanuts. And I, of course, want to hit Gladstone's.
And the pickled eggs.
Any other places in your area, Long Beach, that have pretty good sushi that you want to give a plug to?
Well, you know, there's that place just over the line in the next town over that has the great Korean soy tofu.
Uh-huh, right.
Yeah, and good support customer. She's actually stayed open for takeout business, and got a takeaway from there last week. She said she would be opening for dining service this week. So.
Okay, good.
Yeah, great. So it's open.
Yeah, all right.
In La Palma.
Before I let you go, because we're coming up on our break, I know we're here to talk about Sapporo, okay? I got to ask you about Anchor Steam beer. Just one question. Originally it was called a steamer, correct?
Well, it was called Anchor Steam beer, and it's a genre unto itself.
Right.
There's you're probably familiar. You see my email signature has the fact that I'm Cicerone certified beer server. So
right.
Cicerones are to beer what sommeliers are to wine. And in the test that you take to get the certification, they talk about beer styles. You got Pilsners, Lagers, IPAs, on and on and on. But there's a genre of beer called the California Common. And Anchor Steam is the sole beer in that category.
Right.
So the beer originated in California, San Francisco to be exact, one brewery in the whole universe. And it gets its steam moniker from the fact that it's aged in open fermentation tanks that they would have on the rooftop of the ceiling. And you know how much moisture there is in the air in Texas with all the fog they've got.
Yeah.
So they put hot liquid up there, and steam would just be rolling off of it. So that it was just natural that they named the beer steam.
Boom, there he is, Phil Marti, Sapporo USA. Go out and get one today, tonight. Don't drink and drive, just, you know, take it home with you. Phil, as always, it's been a pleasure.
Thanks for having me, Peter. We'll do it again.
Yes, we will. That's Phil Marti from the Sapporo USA and Anchor Steam Beer. All right, we've got some music in my ears. That means it's time to take a break. But when we come back, I got some more Believe It or Not. It's Peter Dills and the Food Report.
Go Country
105. When you really want a country boot, you've got to get to Columbus. Columbus Italian Steakhouse and Jazz Club, Colorado Boulevard, Eagle Rock. It's that little neighborhood place you wish was down the street from you. Now, citizen, these are trying times, but these are also hungry times. Hungry for some yum-yum for the tum-tum as we long for some semblance of normalcy? Well, Columbus is doing its part by serving up the most succulent steaks, the freshest fish, Columbo's family Italian specialties, the world's greatest meatballs, all for your enjoyment and consumption, and all in the privacy of your home. Yes, it's all pickup. Just call 323-254-9138. And Columbo's will have your order ready for you. And during this time, contact your local and statewide officials and tell them to allow restaurants to open up and do what they do best. Columbo's, that little neighborhood place we need open right now. Columbo's, mind the bend.
Hey everybody, it's Peter Beals for Sapporo Beer. It's the number one selling Asian beer in the United States. It's contemporary, it's stylish, it's food friendly, and it's legendary. Sapporo stands out from the crowd. Since its creation in 1876, Sapporo has been crafted using only the finest ingredients. Sapporo maintains its rich brewing tradition and historical taste profile, which were first modeled after the Bavarian purity law. I love it. When it's warm outside, there's nothing better than a cold Sapporo.
Longo Lexus is California's premier Lexus dealer with amazing deals on over 800 new and pre-owned Lexus vehicles. Longo Lexus is the number one Lexus dealer in the Western area since 1990. 30 years of great people, great products, great service. Visit us today at longolexus.com.
When you really want Italian food, you've got to get to Columbo's. Columbo's Italian Steakhouse and Jazz Club, Colorado Boulevard, Eagle Rock. It's that little neighborhood place you wish was down the street from you. Now, citizen, these are trying times, but these are also hungry times. Hungry for some yum-yum for the tum-tum? As we long for some semblance of normalcy? Well, Columbo's is doing its part by serving up the most succulent steaks, the freshest fish, Columbo's family Italian specialties, the world's greatest meatballs, all for your enjoyment and consumption, and all in the privacy of your home. Yes, it's all pickup. Just call 323-254-9138. And Columbo's will have your order ready for you. And during this time, contact your local and statewide officials and tell them to allow restaurants to open up and do what they do best. Columbo's, that little neighborhood place we need open right now. Columbo's, mangia bene.
So there I am, stuck at home for what felt like an eternity. But you know what? I put that time to good use, like by cleaning my grill, sweeping my patio, and getting ready to finally get the old gang back together again for some summer barbecue fun. Because that's what the best hostesses do. They prepare. So for whatever summer throws at you this year, Smart and Final has you and all your amigos covered with the variety they need at the value you love. Get the best deals delivered right to you by shopping online at smartandfinal.com. Smart and Final. One trip and that's it.
Angels Radio.
AM 830.
Nibbling on sponge cake. Watching the sun bake. All of those tubes covered with oil.
All right, so it's Peter Dills, the food report. Dory's here. A beautiful day here in Southern California.
Yes.
No doubt, no doubt,
amen.
No doubt. All right, I got some restaurants that are open. Diner on Main in Alhambra. Diner on Main in Alhambra. Now, when we give out this information, I do suggest, because things are changing all the time, if I say the Diner on Main is open in Alhambra, I'd call first.
Yeah, call, look it up.
Look it up.
Yeah, yeah, do your homework.
This is the homework that I did, you know? So the Diner on Main in Alhambra is open. Shakers is open. That's in South Pasadena. The Canoe House, where I get my Mai Tais.
That place is awesome.
They are open. And let's see. At the Canoe House, they are doing happy hour 7 days a week to get this thing started right.
Get it rolling.
That's a great idea. There's a question, Lori. What are restaurants doing besides contacting you to get the word out here on our shows? Are you just sitting on your hands hoping that people come in, or are you giving some incentives? I think that Mastro's in Malibu is still offering discounts for to-go items, even though that, you know, they've reopened. So what are the restaurants doing to give you an incentive? So right now, the Canoe House is saying that they're offering happy hour instead of 4 days a week, They're doing it Friday, Saturday. Well, they're doing it all day, all week.
7 days a week.
7 days a week. So that's what should be happening out there. Because if you just tune on to the show, I started the show by mentioning, and this is true, that I have a lot of restaurants calling me, texting me, emailing me, Facebook, and all this stuff. You've called some of the restaurants yourself.
Yes.
Saying, we're not as busy as we thought we'd be. Where is everybody? They couldn't all be in Las Vegas and Arizona.
No, they're right? Here.
They're here.
They're here.
But they're not going out as we thought we would. We, a week ago, or 2 weeks, I don't know. A while ago, when we felt it was so safe to go back to a restaurant and we were allowed to dine in a restaurant, we were told that we had to wait in the car and they would text us. We said, nah, forget about that.
Right.
I'm not in such a hurry that I need to do anything like that. Or, you know, or
to be beckoned to come in.
You are, sir, Dory, you are allowed to come into our restaurant.
We now have enough space for you.
We now have enough space. And then you walk in.
Your Majesty.
You walk in and there's nobody there. My dad used to live in Germany in the late 50s, early 60s. And he would say that these restaurants and these bars, they would have people out in front of the bars, like in a suit, and like a bouncer, a modern day bouncer, but they were dressed up. And they would allow you to walk into the restaurant or the bar. And then you would get in there and either it would be packed or there would be absolutely no one in there.
It was all for show.
It was all for show.
It was like a LA nightclub.
Yeah. So you walk in.
Right.
And there's no one. Cool. What was the name of the, speaking of LA nightclubs, what was the name of the movie with Will Ferrell?
A Night at the Roxbury.
A Night at the Roxbury. Yeah,
Chris Kattan.
And yes. So then they decided.
A lot of bouncing.
Yeah. They decided that they were going to do the nightclub outside.
Yes. And when you get into the nightclub, it looks like you're on the street.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that never great worked. Idea. I tried it. Yeah. It didn't work. All right. An apple a day keeps the doctor away. Oh, by the way.
It's an old one.
An apple a day keeps the doctor away. Fact or fiction? Fiction, Dory. Dory's a fish.
I am a fish. Yeah. Yeah. I know. Oh, man. Don't get me started on that. That's haunted me for the last 15 years.
Oh. Why?
Finding Nemo, when that came out, and Dory made her debut.
Oof, I got one word to say to you, my friend.
What's that?
Spring roll.
Ooh, that's a magic word, isn't
that
it?
That is the magic word, spring roll.
You guys know what that means. Yeah. I've been telling them.
Yeah, all right. Go to Peter at diningwithdills.com. All right, here we go. Does the old adage, does an apple a day keep the doctor away? I was talking to Dory during the break as a runner, as a jogger. I don't drink coffee, but if you need to get yourself get going in the morning and you don't want to have coffee or your whatever, an apple will provide the same amount of lift, juice,
energy
that a cup of coffee will. And that is true because of the sugar in it, okay?
It's very true. It's found that eating an apple a day helps significantly lower levels of bad cholesterol in middle-aged adults. And in 2011, a Dutch study found that eating apples and pears might help prevent strokes. So there is some medical truth.
I better get one of those pears.
Apple and magical pear.
So the original, you had said it was from Wales?
From Wales.
Yeah, UK.
50 years ago.
United Kingdom, Wales.
Right.
Eat an apple on going to bed, and you'll keep the doctor from earning his bread.
I think the American twist is a lot better.
You like that better?
Yeah.
All right.
Our take on stuff usually is the best.
Well, because this is the greatest country in the world.
Amen.
Keep America great, or whatever
that's
it
right.
is. I don't know where that's going.